Hello everyone. Today we are going to continue the same chapter, which is named as heat. So let us continue. Before jumping to the next topic, we shall take a recap of our last video. In our last video, we have learnt about ways of transfer of heat. So let us see how much ways are there for transfer of heat. We have seen there are three ways of transfer of heat. First is conduction, in which the solid gets heated up when it comes in contact with the source of heat. Second is radiation, in which transfer of heat takes place through radiation. It does not require any medium. And the last is convection. The heated molecules rises up and the cooler ones comes down, by which the water and any fluid gets heated up. Next, we have seen land and sea breeze. In daytime, sea breeze, that is the cooler air from the sea, moves towards the land, and the warmer air from the land moves towards the sea. This is termed as sea breeze, and reverse of this happens at the night time, in which the cooler air from the land moves towards the sea and the warmer air from the sea moves towards the land. This is called as land and sea breeze. Now let us see our next topic, which is laboratory thermometer. We have seen that clinical thermometer is used to measure human body temperature. But how do we measure the temperature of other objects? And the answer is with the help of laboratory thermometer. Now let us check how or what is the structure of laboratory thermometer. So laboratory thermometer has bulb at its one end, and in that bulb it has a mercury, which is responsible for showing the temperature. Next is the mercury thread, which rises up or falls down according to the temperature of the object. The range of the laboratory thermometer is generally from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. Clinical thermometer has kink in it, but laboratory thermometer does not have kink, and because of which we have to note the temperature of the object when the thermometer, that is laboratory thermometer, is in the contact with the object. Otherwise, as soon as we take out the laboratory thermometer or we break down the contact of thermometer and the object, the temperature, there are chances that the temperature can fall down and we won't be able to record the exact temperature of the object. Whereas in clinical thermometer, because of presence of kink, the temperature doesn't fall down very rapidly, and we can note it even if the object or the body is not in contact with the thermometer. This is the basic difference between clinical and the laboratory thermometer. The boiling temperature of water is 100 degrees Celsius. So there are different temperature which laboratory thermometer can measure between the range of minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. So here we complete the chapter, which is named as heat, and we shall continue with the next chapter in our next video. Till then, you please be safe, stay home, and keep studying. Thank you.